Hello everyone, coming to you from the Philippines. Welcome again to another video. I'm still in the Philippines, but I did do some coin hunting and finding some stuff that's here in the Republic of the Philippines. So these are newer denomination coins that I found. They changed the 1,000 peso to a new one. Let's take a look at that. It used to look like this with three people on them, and now it is like this with the Philippine eagle. And the nice thing about this, it looks like it's plastic, and you can hear all the roosters cawing in the background. So I am outside so you guys can see what's going on, and we just celebrated the Independence Day here in the Philippines yesterday, so there's still some fireworks going on the background. But anyway, this is the new 1,000 pesos, and as you can see, it is transparent on this side, but it has a special hologram. Let me see if I can put my hand right behind it. See, there's a special hologram with the symbol of the Philippines, Republic of the Philippines, and the Central Bank of the Philippines, called Banco Central de Filipinas. So there is the eagle, and this was all when President Duterte was still around, and now you know it's President Marcos Jr., current president. This is the reverse of the $1,000 bill, and it is plastic in composition, similar to the Canadian version back in the late 2010s, early 2011s and stuff. So I like it. It's nice. It has some security features on there. Now let's go down to the coins. There's no longer a 1 centavo. So the lowest denomination you can get is the 5 centavo. And then followed by the 25 centavo. And then you get the, it's no more heroes back here. We usually put national heroes on the lower denominations and centavos, but they don't do that anymore. So the national hero for the 1 peso is Jose Rizal, which is pretty much the main national hero of the Philippines, and then followed by Andres Bonifacio. He created a rebellion called actually it's not the KKK, similar to the United States. It's a different KKK because it is the rebel alliance against the Spaniards. It's called Kagalang-galang Katipunan. So it's a group of rebellions called the Katipunans, kind of like the Minuteman version militia or something. And this is the Polinario Mabini. He's the next hero that was on there. And this is the 10 peso. And we'll take a look at the reverse on this. And these used to be paper currency. They are no longer paper currency. The 1 peso used to be a paper currency back in the 1970s. So it is now, it's been a coin since the early 80s. And then the 5 peso when I was last here was still around, and the 10 peso and the 20 peso paper money was still around back then. But now they changed it to 5 pesos and coins, 10 pesos in coins, and 20 pesos in coins. So now that is the new one. They're still circulating the old ones, so it's kind of confusing until they phase them out. But this is the new denomination that I found. I like the 20 peso version. This is a bimetallic, kind of like the gaming tokens, but it is 20 pesos. So there's no more 20 pesos until they get rid of all the 20 pesos around. So let's take a look at the reverse on each one. So it shows national plant on each one, central bank logo. There's the kind of like the White House version right there, the Malacanang. That is the White House version, that's where the president lives. And then this one is another one. It's the reverse of the 10 peso. Here's the reverse of the, sorry, I had to swat all these flies. There are flies everywhere. Shoot. And there's the reverse of the 5 peso. The reverse of the 1 peso. And the reverse of the 25 centavos. And then there we have the reverse of the 5 centavo. Okay, so I'm be taking this home, adding it to my collection. Every time I go home to the Philippines, I usually save these coins and currency, but this is the only currency I'm gonna get because there's this is a new one. I still have the previous versions, but I did found this one that I showed you a while ago. I did found this one. It's been used, it's been folded, but look at the serial number. So I said I'm gonna keep that. If that 6 was another 7, this would be a keeper. Real keeper, but it is 5 of a kind, so I am going to keep this one. The reverse on this one is the same as the new one. They just took out the heroes on the back, and on the front. So now it's just the eagle on the front, which I think is good because it represents the symbols of the Philippine country of the Philippines. There is another one that my sister-in-law said the 200 peso used to be in circulation back in the day when I was last here, and now they discontinued it. And this is one of those ones. I found this one, and it's in bad shape, but it's going to be a collector because they don't make these anymore. So I'm saving this. They probably still make them, but not in a good quantity that you can get them. And I even tried the central bank website. They don't have it. Most of the central bank website items, commemorative items, are all out in stock. So this is going to be a keeper. This is definitely going to be a keeper. I'm probably going to see if I can get this graded. And then these, I'll probably find a holder for them and put them all together and add it to the collection. They're all, I think, compositions like copper nickel, and this is like the bimetallic magnesium coated. It's leather edging on there. I don't know if there's any errors on them yet. The minting process here is totally different. Well, that's it from the Philippines, guys. This is the currencies that I've found. I'm gonna keep. I'm probably gonna bring home. Thank you guys all for watching. Thank you for all the love and support. Appreciate each and every one of you. Please stay positive and have a great day.